Right, ladies and gentlemen, I am Brian Lee Crowley. I am the managing director of the Macdonald-Laurier Institute, and on behalf of MLI and our event sponsor, the Latvian Ministry of Defense, I would like to welcome you to this special panel event on Russia's challenge to North American and European security. Thank you very much for coming. There, as you can see, there are very many of you. We've arranged a little, I think, spillover capacity out in the hall with a television monitor if you can't find a place to sit. Just a word about MLI before we get underway, in case there are some of you in the room who are not familiar with us. When we launched the Institute nearly 9 years ago, it was our ambition to provide something previously unknown in Ottawa, a national think tank in the national capital, talking about national issues to national policymakers, the national media, and the national electorate. The international think tank rankings that come out every year from the University of Pennsylvania consistently rank us the top think tank in Ottawa and one of the top four or five in the country. The same rankings found us one of the top three new think tanks in the world in 2013. Our first book, The Canadian Century, Moving Out of America's Shadow, a particularly prescient subtitle, if I may say, won the Sir Anthony Fisher Prize for Top Think Tank Book Internationally just a few years ago. And just last year, our work on Aboriginal Canada and the natural resource economy was shortlisted for the top global prize for think tank project. And just a few months ago, we won the Prospect Magazine Prize for Top Social Policy Think Tank in North America, beating out such American behemoths as the Rand Corporation with a budget of $350 million. We're hot on their tail, I can assure you. National security, defense, and foreign affairs concerns are increasingly moving to the center stage of our work, as this event attests. And within that context, as you may know, MLI has been at the forefront of discussions on NATO's defense of the Baltics, thanks mainly to the hard work of our MLI fellows, two of whom will be on today's panel. Canada has, as everyone knows, a key role in this joint endeavor, having taken up the leadership role as the framework nation of NATO's Enhanced Forward Presence Battle Group in Latvia. When it comes to troops on the ground, Canada's commitment to NATO's collective defense posture remains robust. Indeed, immediately prior to NATO's Brussels summit in July 2018, the Prime Minister renewed Canada's commitment for four more years, more than half a year prior to the expiration of the existing mandate, and in line with the recommendations that MLI has made. So, of course, we take total credit. That shows the country intends to sustain its leadership in this crucial mission. Yet we should also not be blind to the risks of this mission or the potential threat that Russia poses to NATO more generally. The nature of this challenge is the subject of today's event. To say that it is multifaceted would be an understatement, as it ranges from cyber attacks, disinformation, to conventional military and nuclear menacing, and asymmetric warfare. This challenge is particularly felt among the frontline Baltic countries, but it challenges the security and stability of the Atlantic Alliance itself. And through the Kremlin's incessant and all-out information warfare, it can also be felt closer to home amongst all the democracies of the West. Given these dangers, we are pleased to bring together some of the leading Canadian, European, and US thinkers on Russia's challenge to NATO. And I would again like to thank the Latvian Ministry of Defense for their generous support in sponsoring this event. And I would like to welcome Janis Garisons, the State Secretary of the Latvian Ministry of Defense. That's the equivalent of our position of Deputy Minister, who has taken time from his busy schedule to join us today. And Janis, where are you, Janis? Oh, there you are. Good. I knew you were here somewhere. I just didn't know where. Janis has been the State Secretary since August 2015. And in this capacity, he is overseeing a rapid ramping up of both the defense budget and the defense capabilities of Latvia in order to prepare that country for the challenges that it faces. In his previous position as the Undersecretary of State, Policy Director in Latvia's Ministry of Defense, he was an architect and organizer of Latvia's defense policy, defense planning, and international operations policy. He joined the Ministry of Defense after a career in Latvia's Ministry of Foreign Affairs. And I understand that Yanis would like to say a few words, so please join me in welcoming him to the MLI platform. I'll get out of your way.
Well, good morning, and thank you, Brian, for organizing this event. I have to say, I feel to some extent as being at home, because I so frequently meet your soldiers in Latvia, and not only in the bases, but I think what is the most positive thing that we realize, your soldiers are doing a lot of outreach activities. And that probably is one of undervalued thing what we actually have not thought even about before we deployed this mission. Because when they go, they touch with society, and it's the best way, basically, they are the best EU ambassadors, and they are best NATO's ambassadors, because they actually show to the people and they counter Russian narrative. Therefore, I think you should be very proud of your soldiers. Certainly we are, and the thing that they're doing, fabulous. On the subject of this event, I think why it is important to discuss issues. It's important because we have to understand. We have to understand threat, and we have to understand why what we're facing, because it's all about awareness. Because we, in 2014, when Crimea happened and when we saw suddenly unexpected developments, we have to realize, because that was because we actually didn't care, we were careless, and it was lack of awareness. We lived in dream world, in fairy tales were our partners, I would say. And we have to actually, as the situation in Russia develops, we have to follow, and we actually have to recognize how it affect us. Because, as a matter of fact, there's nothing new what Russia is doing and why. And it's the nature of Russia. We simply have to accept that that is as Russia is. But it's, I think, more about us. How we can protect us, how we can be more resilient to all those issues that we're facing. And it's, I think we have to divide that issue. One, understanding what Russia is doing and why it's doing, but also we have to understand how to be resilient to all those things what we are facing. Because at one point, probably not Russia, but somebody other will actually exploit the same things, or the same tools Russia now exploiting. Because I think one thing what we didn't realize is there were shift in global processes. We were very happy about Arab Spring. We were happy about social media. We were happy about many things that were happening. But that happened until the Western world or democracy was actually the dominating one and attractive center of power. Once I think we lost that moment when it actually started accurate. And therefore, suddenly we realized that all the social media, cyber, internet, everything can be used against us. And it can be used by anybody. It's not only about Russia. Therefore, I think the big issue is how to counter all those things and make our society resilient, because it's not only about the military force, but it's also about every citizen of our society. Because if somebody feels insecure, military force will not help. And that is why we currently discovered that even with all rapid military development on our own capabilities, and of course additional forces what Canadian leadership provides us, we need to be more focusing also on our comprehensive approach. We will develop comprehensive defense, where which will focus not only on military, but also whole society. Issues like industry, like civil defenses. Basically, what we need to consider how to make people more secure and confident in the future. But when it comes to Russia, then I think it's we've seen that during Soviet time, and I don't know why people lost. For example, there were this in United States. Even committee of which actually dealt with propaganda issues in during Cold time, and it was nothing different actually. But it's what changed technologies. Now we have social media, we have internet, we have the time changed because everything happens very quickly. And therefore, we have to adjust to all those issues. Russia is simply exploring. Russia has a symptom of inferiority because they want to keep the Soviet part of Soviet ideology, and they only equal what they regard as United States. And of course, it's very difficult to keep equality with the United States if your GDP is less than Canada, as a matter of fact. Therefore, I think we have to give credit to Russians. They found the most effective ways how to affect us, and that is information operations, psychological information, electronic warfare, once we develop more and more capabilities based on technologies, we have to be aware that basically that increases immediately our vulnerability, starting from many other things. But that's how Russia uses their soft power, and I think they found our weak spots, and that I think is the big issue. What we have to deal with, the problem for us, I think, also is there is no similar rules of the game. We are trying to play according to one playbook, and Russians are playing completely with a different playbook, and we have to somehow think how. Where we are and how we can protect our values, because at the end, those are people. That is people's willingness to protect their values, what they believe in, and I think that is basically a big issue for us. Because if you look on Russia, those people are ready to fight, and also not only Russia, but also the Muslim extremists actually. Do the same. They are ready to fight for, not for salary, they are ready to fight for idea. But we somehow, lost that those values, what we are ready to be defended. And I think we have to more take that kind of look. But of course, thank you very much for today's event. I hope we will be able to discover all and discuss those issues related to developments in Russia and how Russia affect us. There, I think, a lot to learn and to share. As I said, we have to, at the end, build awareness and resilience of our societies. Thank you very much.
Well, I'm delighted to hear that Latvians are having such a positive experience with our troops. All I can say is don't ever get on the ice with them. Because anybody who thinks that Canadians are nice has never played hockey.